We've all seen them, and most of us fear them. Motorcycle gang members, hogging the roads, looking menacing, seeming beyond the law. This year, gangs are emerging as an election issue, with demands for police to have wider powers to gain access to gang headquarters. But perhaps not all gangs are the same. The Mothers Motorcycle Club of Palmerston North claim they're not a gang, but a club made up of individuals with a shared common interest in motorcycles and a sense of camaraderie. Recently, the club celebrated its 25th anniversary, and to mark the occasion, they allowed a 2020 team to join them on the road and while they partied. Sean Plunkett reports.
Welcome to Mother's Day, biker style. Every second Sunday in May, motorcycle enthusiasts from throughout the country join the Mothers Motorcycle Club on their annual run. This year, close to 250 take to the road. It's one day of the year when patched bikers, white-collar and blue-collar workers can share their common interests, bikes and partying on. The mothers see it as a highly social occasion, to which all are welcome. It's all about breaking down barriers. But it's guaranteed to attract the attention of the police, as participants discovered at a surprise roadblock set up on State Highway 3, just out of Palmerston North.
Keep going. Thank you, Mr. Lynch. How much have you had this afternoon?
I've had one for you.
Okay. You're right there, because that is a negative screening test.
Bikers confront District Commander Mark Lammas with allegations of assault.
What's your number and your name? You assaulted her, you hit her on the head. What's your number and your name? What's your number and name?
I'll talk to you very shortly.
No, you
stay here. I'm not going anywhere. I'll talk to you very shortly.
You assaulted this woman?
Stand over there. I'll give you all the details you need.
Provocative? Confused?
The run continues with Mother's president, Craig Weller, at the front. The rule is, no one overtakes him. He admits for many, meeting up with 250 bikes can be daunting, with the public not wanting to look beyond the patches.
Seeing a really large majority of bikes going past your car as you're driving on the road, I guess you're only intimidated because you're scared of the noise and all the bikes riding past you. No one's going to reach over and smash the window and make you horse off the road or anything like that. And we're just riding past, heading to the next stop, have another yarn and carry on to the next stop.
Himatangi Wines is a welcome venue.
Yourself?
Yeah, always, mate.
Did you have a
Sometimes.
The mothers claim the many who mix with them are proof their attempt to be part of the community is working.
And we just opened up a shop in Bunnybrook.
Yeah, you've got
it. Secondhand shop. We sell things from smaller appliances to clothing, baby's clothing, adults. Pretty hard for us to get men's clothing because men tend to wear their clothes until nothing left. Kerry, you're getting grey, man. You're getting grey, you're catching up to me. Been dyeing your hair.
Grecian 2000. You can talk.
Some remember past glory days.
Friday, Saturday night outside the Boy Milk Bar, and went from there, and then we decided to become the Wolfpack. And everybody liked that name because we used to get hunt out in packs, chasing the shillers and stirring the cops up.
It won't rain, will it?
Surely not. For Craig Weller, there's no time for idle chat. The run is behind schedule.
We'll catch up. Yeah, well, help him be a quick one.
No, so you don't have to stay too long?
No, help him be a quick one. Money can be a quick one. Mm. Back in the town, the job's tidy. It won't take long. How many police cars have we got out there?
Two.
And that's it.
Runs now into its second leg along State Highway 1. So far, unlike previous runs, no one has fallen off. There are no casualties and all the bikes arrive intact at the Sanson Hotel car park. It's time for a gossip, a chance to examine the thousands of dollars of hardware on show. The Harleys, the Nortons, the Triumphs. Japanese bikes are notable by their absence. Craig Weller knows some may think they are just men playing boys' games.
There's a lot of people that sort of would say that you have been childish or whatever, but they haven't got what I've got. You know, I've got the brotherhood that I've been seeking all my life. I found it nearly 10 years ago now, and I wish to stay here for as long as I can. They're just jealous. They have to be. You know, I'm living a good life as far as I can tell, you know.
Meanwhile, back at the roadblock, after all the effort and expense of helicopters and extra staff, only four people are taken away by police. But police say they are more than happy. Craig Weller sees things differently.
Well, really, we expected this sort of stuff to go on, but not as bad as with the choppers in the skies and the roadblocks like they turn and all the extra police they've brought in. It's just wasting their time. I mean, we've done the Mother's Day run for nearly 25 years now. And there's been no trouble whatsoever. They're just out to try and wreck the weekend for everybody, that's all, and spend the taxpayers' money on something that they shouldn't be spending it on.
With all the bikes now parked up at the Bunnythorpe Tavern, police take the chance to check warrants and registration. Despite the tension, both sides are trying to keep things relaxed. Bikers accept easing this tension will always be a challenge. No,
yeah. It's all right when you go out, we're on the road and you go and pull us up. We come up here to get breathalyzed tested to save this problem.
Yeah, but it's not a service that the department provides, is it? You can't call on that service any time of the day or the
week.
Well,
they haven't got any in the pub where you can...
No, they don't have any hotels that do that. See the point I'm trying to make? If there's been medication or... Drugs or something of that nature.
Hard night,
yeah.
The anniversary run ends at Palmerston North's Firecat Strip Club. but riders aren't worried that it endorses the stereotyped image of a biker's hangout. Mother's clubhouse covers several acres on the outskirts of Palmerston North. As the party continues the next day, police interest continues.
How you going, Craig?
All right.
As we discussed yesterday, we just want to come through the bar, okay?
Yeah.
So you're going to accompany us?
Yeah, we'll come here.
Okay, lead on, guys.
When I'm not here.
You go.
His name will be written on the board up here. It's his duty manager, and he'll be here if I'm not.
Okay. If there's any problems, you're going to give us a ring, aren't you?
Mate, we've got your cell phone number.
Good on you.
All right. You will give us a ring if there are any problems, won't
yeah.
you?
We don't have the problems, sir.
Okay. Good on you, guys.
Okay. Is that an apple?
No, thanks, mate.
Sure.
Sure. Oh, there you go. Thank you.
Bye-bye. Bye. Have a good day.
Thank you.
Baz Fox is former president of the Mothers. He's weathered years of anti-bikey feeling.
You find a lot of guys that hang around in clubs have probably come from harder lifestyles. And what you actually find is the brotherhood and the camaraderie and the friendship that's extended is something that's needed in their life.
He says the club's speedway track is evidence of their involvement in the community.
It's not so much for us, but for the younger people. It gives them an opportunity to ride a bike, see what it's like, long before they have to spend the money to do it.
But it takes little encouragement for Baz and his mates to get out on the track themselves.
We get this adrenaline rush from the race that we can't get from anything else. Otherwise, we would be doing these other things. We get out there, we line up, and we race. And you have no brakes. And for about a couple of minutes there ain't nothing else that matters in the whole world. Except the cohesion between you and your swinger and the way the bike runs. Now, what you put in is what you get out.
Cars are usually shunned by the Mothers, but even a car has its uses, particularly on the speedway track. The Mothers, though, are bikers through and through. From their annual bike show, with money raised going to local charities, to their Manfield track race days. Baz says as long as they're not hurting anyone, they don't really care what the public thinks.
I think it's about time they got with it. It's not the 70s anymore. It's 1996. Man's been on the moon for 26, 28 years. let's face it, you see a group of bikes riding down the road now, you don't have to be scared. You don't have to drive off the road. You want to look at the opportunity of saying, hey, there's a free bike show here. Let's pull up and have a look. Let's see some of these Harleys. Let's have a look and see what they're riding. Take that attitude rather than the attitude of, it's a gang, I'm scared, I'm terrified. It's all in the way you look at things, I believe. But at the same token, we are members of a motorcycle club, and basically we don't take a lot of shit. We're pretty straight up people, we get on with people, we conduct our business in a business manner. We are what we are.